Lalo na po yung mga galing sa Iloilo pa na nagpunta dito. This public hearing of the Senate Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drugs is called to order. On December 10, 2015, your Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drugs held a legislative meeting in the session hall of the Iloilo Provincial Capital in Iloilo City to gather facts and information in relation to proposed Senate Resolution 1673-1674 filed by Senator Nancy Binay, and this representation regarding the brazen attempt by alleged members of a local drug syndicate to enter and attack DYOK Aksyon Radyo Iloilo. Said legislative meeting was attended by provincial city and barangay officials of Iloilo, the PDEA, PNP, DILG, officials from the Pardons and Parole Office, officers of the National Union of Journalists of the Philippines, members of local media, the station manager of Aksyon Radyo, and one of those who entered and attacked the radio station. After 3 hours of discussions, presentations, reports, and statements, the legislative meeting yielded the following facts, among others. Number one, Mr. John Paul Tia, Mr. Tia, station manager of Aksyon Radyo, showed CCTV footages and narrated in full as to what happened in the radio station. In a nutshell, more or less, 20 men who appeared to be armed stormed into the premises of Aksyon Radyo, but failed to enter the building, and their leader removed one CCTV camera, and they all fled. The three of these men were identified as Melvin Odicta Sr., the group's leader, Melvin Odicta Jr., his son, and Jesus Jingjing Espinosa, a barangay kagawad of Monica Blumentritt, Iloilo City. The release from imprisonment of Melvin, number two, the release from imprisonment of Melvin Odicta Sr. and Jingjing Espinosa was questioned, as members of the media maintained that their release seems not to be in order for lack of proper documents to back it up. Next, PDEA officials reiterated their request for the inclusion of drug-related cases in the exceptions of the anti-wiretapping law. PDEA officials expressed their difficulty in pinning down the leaders of drug syndicates because said leaders do not possess, sell, trade, manufacture, or transport drugs directly, and they exercise command and control over their underlings. Next, the PDEA reported on the status of the province of Iloilo and Iloilo City in relation to the problems of illegal drugs. Next, the members of the media, however, maintained that the problem on illegal drugs still persists in Iloilo despite all the statistics that came from the PDEA, PNP, and the LGUs. The president and national director of the National Union of Journalists of the Philippines offered suggestions and new approaches in battling illegal drugs, such as going after the financials and bank records of the drug lords. Next, Mr. Tia lamented PNP's failure to resolve previous cases of harassment perpetrated against Aksyon Radyo. He likewise informed the committee of their lack of trust to their local police. He further claimed that the local drug syndicates have people inside the police station. Those were some of the highlights of the legislative meeting in Iloilo City. Before said meeting was ended, we pinpointed particular actions to be taken, namely, number one, study the possibility of introducing the concept of plea bargaining in our Dangerous Drugs Act to lure members of drug syndicates to turn on their bosses and leaders. Number two, with PDEA's recommendation, the passage of relaxing the wiretapping law in cases of terrorism and drug trafficking must be hastened. Number three, to fully implement the existing memorandum order on the activation of the Anti-Drug Council in each local government, citizens' participation must be encouraged. And number five, the cases filed against Melvin Odicta Sr., Melvin Odicta Jr., and Jingjing Espinosa must be monitored and safeguarded closely. Next, the dubious release from imprisonment of Melvin Odicta Sr. and Jingjing Espinosa must be investigated. And number six, the PNP and PDEA must look into the allegations made by Iloilo City Councilor Nava against Jingjing Espinosa and other disclosures made. And last, the PNP's Internal Affairs Service must likewise look into the alleged involvement of some local police with the local drug syndicates. Ngayong umaga, naririto po tayo sa Senado bilang simbolo pa rin na ang pakikipagpulong natin sa taong bayan at opisyales ng probinsya at syudad sa labas ng Metro Manila ay magdudulot ng mga aksyon at pagkilos ng ating national government. Nais natin ipakita na ang ating laban kontra illegal na droga ay walang pinipiling lugar, syudad o probinsya. Walang pinipiling personalidad, walang pinipiling oras at walang atrasan. Nais din natin ipakita ang kagandahang naidulot ng partisipasyon at kooperasyon ng ating barangay anti-drug abuse councils at ang ating local government units hanggang sa level ng barangay. Nais din natin ipakita na handa tayong pagtibayin at palakasin ang ating mga batas upang tugunan ang kaakibat na paglala ng problema ng ilegal na droga. I would like to acknowledge the presence of the following: Senator Tito Soto. We also have Attorney Mark Piad, Attorney Rex Aloba. Honor, City Councilor Nava. Assistant Prosecutor Jinky Dedumo, the DOJ. Ma'am. Police Superintendent Antonio Guardiola Jr. Sir, Yusek Arturo Kakdak Jr., morning. Police Director Jonathan Ferdinand G. Miano, Police Chief Superintendent Pedro Obaldo Jr., Mr. Paul Ledesma, Regional Director, PDEA Region 6, ASEC Lemos, Deputy Director General for Operations, PDEA, Mr. Joel C. Eggo, President, National Press Club. Sir. Represent, and we also have Mr. Fred Villarreal, DepSec General, NUJP. Sir. Ms. Len Olea, Director, NUJP. Good morning, ma'am. And Mr. John Paul Tia, Station Manager, Aksyon Radyo Iloilo. Sir. Thank you for your presence. Before we start, and to refresh our memory as well as for Senator Soto, may I request the CCTV video on the attempted break-in of Aksyon Radyo to be shown again. Mr. Tia, or the cameraman, to please activate. I would like also to acknowledge the presence of Mr. Marianito Dima Andal, Director, Malacanang Records Office. Sir, thank you. Meron ba tayong ma-activate na? Okay. So we'll give it a few minutes.
Madam Chair. Oh, it's all right.
Madam Chair, Senator Soto, good morning. I could not really remember the camera angles. We do not have specific names for these cameras, but this is one of the angles taken from one of the CCTV cameras of Aksyon Radyo Iloilo. This is at the front of the building, which is being occupied by Aksyon Radyo Iloilo. We occupy the third floor. We share the third floor with another tenant. This is a four-story building, and this is the front or the facade of the building leading towards the offices of Aksyon Radyo Iloilo. Nakita po natin yung isang tao from this angle na pinipigilan. Apparently, he is attempting to enter the premises of the station. Ayun pong namumuno was later on identified as Mr. Melvin Odicta. So that was from the first camera angle. of the station, footages from the first camera of the station. In yet another angle, and this is along Senator Ninoy Aquino Avenue, we would later on see, makita po natin na pumarada yung kotse ni Mr. Melvino Dicta. This is a luxury sedan owned by Mr. Odicta. Sasampa po yan sa gutter. And then he's going to exit his vehicle and try to force his way into the fenced perimeter of the building. Makikita po naman natin na very clearly na fenced yung labasa nung building. That is Mr. Odicta, Your Honors. He apparently is holding on to something by his waist. On his waist, and yun na po yung mga tao niya. Marami pa po sila. It is worth mentioning, Your Honors, that this happened at in the wee hours of the morning of November 11, 2015, at around past 1 o'clock in the morning. The people na makakasama po ni Mr. Melvino Dicta were on board a Toyota van and another vehicle. It did not take them that long para umattempt na pumasok tsaka kuhanin yung CCTV camera ng station. Ganun po sila karami at meron pa po silang kasamaan by the side ng building. The vehicle na andun pa po sa unahan ay kasama rin po nila. So that's from the second angle ng camera ng station, Your Honors. We can proceed with that. This is a third angle. This is from the area ng restaurant na owned by Mr. Melvino Dicta. They're going to come from the right side ng road. Ito po yung sasakyan ni Mr. Melvino Dicta. Ito na po yung mga kasamahan niya. That's the fourth car. Yung mga tao po kanina na nakita natin na trying to accompany Mr. Odicta came from this van. So we're counting one. Isa pala po yung lumabas, but there will be others. It's two, three. 14. So that's a third angle. Sa, kuha po yan sa tatlong camera ng istasyon na Madam Chair, Your Honor, Senator Soto. Since 2 months ago, Madam Chair, Senator Soto, a little more than 2 months ago, Your Honors, a case for grave threats, robbery, and qualified trespass to dwelling was filed against three out of the more or less 20 men who tried to break into the building occupied by Aksyon Radyo Iloilo. And despite the local police pronouncements last December 16 that they have already identified five other suspects, apparently as up to this date, no supplemental complaint affidavit was filed. On January 4, and there has been too little, very minuscule amount of developments in as far as the case is concerned. On January 4, Mr. Melvino Dicta, through counsel, filed this counter affidavit claiming that he had no violent or ill intentions in having tried to break into the premises of Aksyon Radyo, but all that he wanted to do was to relieve himself in the proximity of the building where the office of Aksyon Radyo is situated. Your Honors, Madam Chair, it has been a standstill after that. Thank you, Your Honors.
Thank you, Mr. Tia, for your annotations and also your comments, updates. Senator Soto.
Madam Chair, if the report I received is correct, the committee conducted the hearing in Iloilo.
It's an investigation. Meeting investigation.
Before we proceed further, may we be briefed on what transpired and what happened in the committee meeting or consultation or investigation that happened in Iloilo, so that we can complete the picture?
What transpired, Senator Soto, was first there was also a presentation from Aksyon, and then we also had one of the alleged involved during the incident, the Barangay Kagawad, who is being implicated. He was one of the ones that stormed the radio station. Apparently, he has a connection with two powerful drug lords in Iloilo. He also has a pending murder case, or he had a murder case, but he was pardoned, apparently. And then also one of the ones that
case pardoned by who?
That's also another one that we wanted to thresh out. Then one of the other persons being implicated, the one who was present also during the storming of Aksyon Radyo, is Melvin Odicta Sr., who is being accused of being one of the top drug pushers in Iloilo. And he was also convicted and pardoned, but then there are no records of his pardon or even him having been incarcerated. So this is really part of our investigation. And there are also some allegations that local government officials are involved. And as Mr. Tia mentioned, the cases are quite slow to come by or be filed against those that are involved. So we also have a brief summary of what happened.
Thank you, Madam Chair. If I may continue with that as a setting, I think the Department of Justice should be called by your committee and the Department of Interior and Local Governments because of the personalities involved and because of the so-called cases that have been filed, or not only filed, but if the report is accurate, this guy Odicta was sentenced to life imprisonment. And why is he roaming around in Iloilo with a firearm? May we ask the PNP to check the Firearms and Explosive Unit kung ano-ano mong lisensyang baril na meron itong si Udicta? Why can he carry a firearm in doon sa Iloilo? Kung convicted siya. Ano? Do we have the DOJ here? Yes, may perhaps you can give us a brief on who this person is. According to the reports, he is a sentenced. He was sentenced to life imprisonment for drug trafficking, violation of the Dangerous Drugs Act. Why is he scot-free, Attorney De Dumo?
Sir, good morning, Senator Poe and Senator Soto. Just for the record, I was just informed to appear and to attend in today's public hearing, so I have yet to gather some facts and information regarding this case, Your Honor. I just came from the MCLE, but I'm doing my best to be here. I just asked permission. But for the information asked, I will do my best to secure that upon my return from the seminar. But for now, I don't have that data yet.
And while you're doing that, include also the name of that barangay captain. What's the name of that barangay captain who's also a convict?
Just for clarification, the DOJ sent us a letter on December 22. And it says, please be informed that based on the records of the Board of Pardons and Parole, that the Parole and Probation Administration, Mr. Odicta, has never been granted parole, nor has he been under probation. We would like to inform you further that based on the records of the Bureau of Correction, he was released by virtue of their petition for habeas corpus.
Paano nangyari yun? He was convicted of what? Do you have an answer, the Director General Kaltak?
In support, sir, of the Department of Justice, we have here records that indicate that he was indeed convicted, Your Honor. But a new
convicted
law
of what? What section?
He was convicted for violating Republic Act 6425. And
ay, luma pa.
Yes, Your Honor. But
what section?
I'll look into
what section?
The specific section, Your Honor. But just to proceed, I would like to report that Republic Act 67659 was enacted, which lowered the penalty for the offense that was committed by.
What was his offense?
Possession, trafficking. Section 20, Your Honor. Article 4 of Republic Act 6425. Because of the volume of drugs, Your Honor,
it was
covered by the Republic Act 7659. That's based on our records.
Well, nevertheless, he's a convict.
Yes, Your Honor.
No? Why is the PNP allowing him to have a firearm? He's a convict. Bakit kakalat-kalat may baril? Tsaka ang daming kasama, ang tatapang ah. Madalas yung mga ganyan karami, matatapang pag marami. May we be informed? Yes, PNP.
Madam Chair, I have heard the report of the City Director of Iloilo City Police Office informing that there was a verification conducted whether the three identified persons are firearm holders, and the three are indeed authorized firearm holders. However, yes, sir. However, the license of Mr. Espinosa already expired, and he voluntarily surrendered his caliber 45 to the city police officer.
What about Udikta and the other personality? What is the name of the other person?
Melvin Udikta Senior and Melvin Udikta Junior, sir.
Sino sa kanila yung pumapasok na may barrel? Sino sa kanila yun? Yung junior o yung senior? Yung senior. Sino yung convict? Yung senior. And based on your records, the FEU granted him a license?
Yes, sir. Based on the report of the City Director of Iloilo Police, sir. Mr. Melvin Udikta Jr. and Melvin Udikta Sr. are firearm license holders.
And they have permit to carry? They have PTCs?
It was not determined, sir, but we'll find out, sir.
Please inform us. They have PTCs, and who issued the PTC?
Yes, sir.
Are you allowed to ever be issued a license for a firearm if you've been convicted? Even if you've been paroled or granted a commutation of your sentence?
By special permission, I understand, no? Is that right? Or you are never allowed?
It depends on the case, sir.
Huh?
It depends on the case. If he is offending, if it's a previous case of shooting or use of firearms, he will be disqualified to have a license, to be licensed with firearms.
What about drug trafficking?
Right now, before you can get a firearms license, you should be able to have a license to own and possess firearm. So before you can have that, your record must show that you have not been convicted or accused of committing a crime, the use of firearms.
Sir, how about the long firearms carried around by Jingjing Espinosa in the picture shown by Councilor Nava? Remember there was a picture that Councilor Nava presented before during our investigation. He was posing, I believe he posted it. And here clearly, Udikta Sr. has a gun somewhere. Councilor Nava.
Thank you, Your Honor, Senator Paul, Senator Soto. To answer the question of Senator, before I proceed to Kagawa Jingjing Espinosa showing his barrage of firearms and ammunitions, to answer the question of Senator Soto as to the firearms of Melvin Udikta and his son, Melvin Udikta Jr., we have gathered official information from the PNP in Iloilo City. The following are the firearms registered in the name of Melvin Udikta Sr., the one who is holding a firearm, the one who led the group. Here are the firearms registered in his name, Your Honor. AK-47, high-powered rifle, caliber 7.62 with serial number 5200050, issued on October 23, 2015 with expiry date on March 14, 2019.
Licensed?
Yes, sir. I will continue. So you will be surprised how many firearms it was issued to him.
Number two, I have begun ng lisensya.
Yes, sir.
I have no driver. I have no security. I only rely on my shooting proficiency. And they do not want to give me a license for my mini Uzi. But that they are giving an AK-47
yes,
to a felon.
Till 2019. Till 2019.
I will continue, Your Honor. Because, you know, narco politics exists in Iloilo City. That's why these things happen in Iloilo City. Number two, pistol black caliber 9mm with serial number ENU539 issued on October 23, 2015 with expiry date on March 14, 2019. Number three, shotgun Daewoo caliber 12 gauge with serial number F600564 issued on October 23, 2015 with expiry date on March 14, 2019. Number 4, pistol 6-over caliber 45 with serial number GS05530 issued on October 23, 2015 with expiry date on March 14, 2019. Number 5, high power rifle tabor caliber 5.56 with serial number 40801444 issued on October 23, 2015 with expiry date on March 14, 2019. Next, high power rifle Colt caliber 5.56 with serial number 880828 issued on October 23, 2015 with expiry date on March 14, 2019. Next, revolver Smith & Wesson caliber 44 with serial number CJA0046 issued on October 23, 2015 with expiry date on March 14, 2019. Next, revolver Taurus caliber 38 with serial number ES92701 issued on October 23, 2015 with expiry date on March 14, 2019. Next, pistol 6-over caliber 40 with serial number U674506 issued on October 23, 2015 with expiry date on March 14, 2019. These firearms are registered in the name of Melvin Odicta Sr. The following firearms are registered in the name of Melvin Odicta Jr., the one who accompanied his father. Number 1, shotgun Benelli caliber 12 gauge with serial number M273762. Issued on August 4, 2015 with expiry date on March 22, 2019. Number 2, pistol, Kimber, caliber 45 with serial number K328848 issued on August 4, 2015 with expiry date on March
22, 2019. Excuse me, Councillor, who is the issuing officer of all the firearms of the Odicta Senior?
The FE.
How many? Lahat-lahat yung kay senior?
Yes.
Total ilan?
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, Your Honor. 9 firearms.
9 kasama yung AK?
Yes, and tabor.
Oh, 9. Okay. Sino issuing officer?
Yung FEU, Firearms Explosive Unit, mismo sa camp, Your Honor, because the licensing, the issuance of licenses and PTC outside the residence should come from Camp Krami. And these records, this was actually submitted by PNP.
Sino ang nakapirma?
We have no copy of the firearms itself. What we have is just a list issued by the PNP in Iloilo City, particularly in Region 6, Your Honor. Those firearms I have mentioned earlier are all registered to one person, Melvin Odicta Sr. And the succeeding firearms are listed in the name of his son, the one who accompanied, the one who was trying to prevent his father from barging inside the
action. How many are licensed to the
to son? The son, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 firearms, runner, shotgun and pistols, 2 shotguns, and 4 pistols, Your Honor.
Pero mukhang level-headed yung anak, ano? Dahil inaawat niya.
Well, I cannot speak for the character of the son.
Okay, let me go back. Just rewind a little, Madam Chair, if you don't mind. I'm puzzled at how selling or Section 20 can be reduced, ano? Even with Republic Act 9165, okay? Republic Act 6425, I will admit, has its loopholes, all right? But not Section 20. There is no loophole in Section 20. That is selling, eh. Di ba? Now, when we enacted the Republic Act 9165, humanap sila ng palusot, sinabi nila bakit yung amount does not fall under what, 200 grams? Ano amount? Ano amount? I think DOJ should look into this. Marijuana ba yung selling? Okay, ano amount? 50 grams lang. Pero ang sinasabi ng 9165 kasi, 1 kilo. Di ba? Ang automatic, non-bailable, di ba? So binaba, nung sinabing 50 grams lang, lumakad siguro sa DOJ o sa korte na sinabi na mababa na ito eh. Kesa doon sa Republic Act 165. But not 9165 is very explicit in saying na kahit 1 gram, pag nagbebenta ka, kahit isang stick, pag nagbebenta ka, is drug trafficking. Paano pinayagan ng korteng ibaba yun?
Your Honor, may I explain? He was charged for violating Republic Act 6425 and then he was convicted, Your Honor. But in 19...
The sentence was life imprisonment.
In 1991...
Selling, ano? Selling.
Oh. Yes, Your Honor. In 1991, Republic Act number 7659 was enacted into law, lowering the penalty for...
Yes. No, 2001. No.
1991, Your Honor.
Ah, 7659. Okay, okay, go ahead.
7659. Now, the volume of drugs that were recovered from him was covered under this law because it is lower than the 750 grams or more of Indian hemp or marijuana. That's why it was the Regional Trial Court of Muntinlupa, Metro Manila, issued an order of release in May 4, 1995, Your Honor, way before Republic Act 9165.
But 7659, what is the penalty for selling in 7659?
Your Honor, it did not amend the law, it just lowered the penalties, Your Honor. It just lowered the penalties imposed on certain volumes of drugs recovered.
Oh, therefore, hindi qualified. Dahil hindi binaba yung penalty. Nga mo, yung lower lang, yung volume ni lower eh.
Hindi na po na-cover nung, that is my interpretation, Your Honor. May I request the assistance of the lawyer from the DOJ?
No, may we ask, baka kinapag-aralan pa lang ng DOJ ito. Attorney, may, pwede bang isama ninyo yung sa dapat ninyong pag, i-review? Ano? Paano sila nakakuha ng reduction of sentence? At paano silang naka-release, ano? And then we want a report from the PNP on paano yung binibigyan ng lisensya. I'm sure Aidsot will not agree. Ano? Paano nabigyan ng lisensya yung convict? At may high-powered firearms. Na nung nag-uusap kami ni Rick, sabi ko, paano yung mini-Uzi? Pwede ba? Hindi, kailangan i-semi-automatic. Yung AK-47, mas matindi pa yun eh. Bakit may lisensya yun? Eh ako, chief ng PNP yung kausap ko, sabi sa akin, hindi pwede. Di ba? So, I want Madam Chair, I want a complete report from the PNP about this. Chief Ubaldo wants to have the floor, Madam.
As per report of Ioilo City Police Officer, na there is already a request for the revocation of all the firearm licenses of Melvin Orikta, Senior Melvin Orikta Jr., and Jesus Jingjing Espinosa.
Who is making that request again, sir?
The provincial director of the city director of Ioilo City Police.
When was this sent to you? This request.
There was a request dated November 27, and the Office of the Chief INE Section EMD Head Secretariat Firearms License Revocation and Restoration Board, Kamkram, Quezon City is now conducting the investigation, sir. Ma'am.
Conducting the investigation? Shouldn't
yes,
it be? Until how long does it take for them to be able to revoke if?
We will try to find out, ma'am.
Director General, do you have anything to add regarding this? When you asked for a copy of the firearms, Councilor Nava, mabilis lang naman na ibigay sa inyo.
It was actually given to Aksyon Radyo.
By the PNP?
Yes, Your Honor.
It came from one of our police sources, Madam Chair.
So it had to be a source, hindi officially ito na nakuha.
But he is a police official, Madam Chair.
Okay, no, I understand, but this should be easily accessible. Eh. So it had to be from a source instead of the PNP volunteering to give it to them if you asked it from them. Mr. Ledesma, do you have anything to add regarding this? Do you have any reservations, for example, that the Odictas have that much firearms?
Good morning, ma'am. Us in PIDEA, we just enforce the drug law. We don't really consider if they have that much firepower because being government law enforcement, we also have equally same high-powered rifles. However, on the ground, it makes a lot of difference because the firearms they possess are not really against us. It's just more to show their underlings, to cloud them with the ambiance of fear and that of their competition. So it's more of a propaganda tool rather than really to be used against law enforcement action against them. No? So per se to us, it's not a concern, but to the others, it's a major concern. Ma'am. It projects power, and power there in our area also results in a lot of influence.
I agree with you. This could also be a show of force that basically instead of them utilizing it against you. But the reality is if you have to confront them in a situation, that's also pretty threatening for the lives of our law enforcement officers. I would like to ask the PNP. The Internal Affairs Office of the PNP said there's an investigation report on the Aksyon Radyo Iloilo incident, which was already completed. So I'd like to know what is the status of this investigation and being done by the IAS. How exactly is the IAS doing its investigation on the local police of Iloilo? When will the IAS complete the investigation findings and recommendations? Do you have any information on that?
We don't have the records on that right now, ma'am.
Do you have any investigation on the local police, any local police or law enforcement group that is actually cuddling or supporting the Odictas in Iloilo or protecting them?
Yes, Madam Chair. In fact, the Iloilo City Police Office have already filed the case of grave threats, robbery upon things, trespassing.
Against
who? The three identified and John Doe's, Your Honor.
Three identified John Doe's?
Yes, the three identified persons plus John Doe's.
Three identified plus John Doe's?
Yes.
But are there any, do you have any PNP or any police officer involved in this? In the operations or allegations that they are involved. Apedea, do you have any information that local law enforcement is protecting a certain group?
We have requested the PNP to look at the video. They might recognize certain individuals.
Aksyon, meron ba kayong impormasyon na protektado sila ng pulis o mayroon mga nasa posisyon na mayroong kinalaman dito?
Madam Chair, Your Honor, we do not want to jump into a conclusion, a haphazard conclusion that would put active and retired members of the Philippine National Police as being guilty by association. But in one instance, we were able to get an entry from the logbook of a shooting range in Iloilo. I don't know if I still have this, but let me check with your indulgence, Your Honor.
Go ahead, sir. That's fine. While you're looking for it, do you have it? Yeah.
This is an entry in a shooting range in Iloilo, Your Honor, with the names of the following identified members of the PNP who tested a newly purchased firearm together with the son of Mr. Melvin Odicta, Lino Duarte, I think he's a retired member of the Philippine National Police, Amat Trill, the initials are VC, but I think this is Vicente or Amat Trill, Romeo Hualde, who is a retired member of the Philippine National Police, Ed Moon Defensor, Rick Poblador, Joey Rodellado, and an unidentified employee of the Iloilo City Government. He used to be an executive assistant for the city mayor, Jeffrey Celis.
And they're all former PNP. Most of them are former, no active.
I'm not sure about the rest, but I think Mr. Amat Trill is an active duty member of the Philippine National Police, Madam Chair.
Is it possible also that since it's a shooting range, that they would all be there coincidentally practicing?
They went there as a group, Madam Chair.
As a group, okay. Councillor.
Madam Chair, in fairness to IAS, they went to Iloilo City and they talked to me. They came from Camp Crami. And I submitted to them a blue book. This blue book was left by my client, a police officer, before he was killed. He was assassinated, Your Honor. This is the picture. The picture where when he was killed. He was killed last January 6 or 7, 2014. He's my client because he had a lot of criminal cases, although he was a bemedaled police officer. Before he was killed, he left me in his own handwriting because he was from the intelligence before. In his own handwriting, he wrote all the protectors of the Odicta group. I gave the original copy to the IAS. I trusted them that they would conduct this investigation. And the remaining part is just a machine copy. Aside from that, he also left me with this little notebook. In his own handwriting, he also stated, mentioned, and wrote down the names of police officers and other officials who have been cuddling, protecting Melvin Odicta and his Odicta group. Not only Odicta group, but the other group of Pubindido, because there are two major drug personalities identified by PDEA. Before, we only heard aliases. They called them Dragon, Buang, and Bunjing. Without the Aksyon Radyo incident, we would not have known that this Dragon, always mentioned by PDEA, is the same, is Melvin Odicta Sr. My client is Espiritu, the late Espiritu Rex Jules Reyes. I have a file of his. By the way, these are the killers of the police officer. They were all captured after the incident.
Are they in any way?
And some of them, one of them, used to work with car wash as car wash boy of Melvin Odicta, because Melvin Odicta has a fleet of taxis in Iloilo City, as you know, sort of telling us that he has legitimate businesses. He has restaurant taxis operating in the city of Iloilo. And one of those who were captured, one of the gunmen captured by the responding police officers, is identified as one of the car wash boys of Odicta. And now the lawyer of these five are the same lawyers who are now defending Odicta in that case filed by Aksyon Radyo against him. I don't want to make an assumption that he is the one who had SPO2 Rex Rosales killed.
Now, the lawyers, are they De Campanillang lawyer ito sa Iloilo. Mga kilala.
Well,
hindi mo kailangan sabihin ng pangalan. I'm just saying.
Yes,
kung,
Your Honor.
Kung ito, car wash boy, how will they be able to afford a lawyer like that is my question. So, yes.
His lawyer is also a convicted felon before who stayed at Munting Lupa. He was convicted for the crime of killing one of the singers of Asin. After he was released from prison, he went back to Iloilo City and continued his practice of law.
He was not disbarred?
There was no petition for disbarment. And in fact, I am also a lawyer. I am also a practicing lawyer. We meet in some cases involving some drug personalities handled by these two lawyers, because the two lawyers of Udicta usually handle drug cases in Iloilo City. I would like to submit this, although for the record, I have already submitted this to IAS, the original copy of this. I don't know whether it is true, whether this is correct, whether this is founded, this has basis why Rex wrote this in his own handwriting. I do not know his motive. As far as I'm concerned, I kept this, Your Honor, for 2 years. And I did not know why he has to trust me in telling me that as city councilor, as his lawyer, he gave me this. And I would like to submit this photocopy because some of the names are present here. So I don't want to tarnish the image of some person's name here who are present here today. So it would be unfair to them, because there's always a presumption of innocence. And I do not know what motivated SPO2 Rex de los Reyes to write all the names of this person here. But in confidentiality, I would like to submit this to the good senator.
Of course, we will accept it. My question is this. You submitted the original to the IAS. Did you have any receipt that it was received by them, number one? Number two, when did you submit it? And do you have any reply from them whatsoever?
I submitted it when they went to Aksyon Radyo.
When was this? Last year?
No, just this December.
So after December?
Yeah, after the inquiry.
After our inquiry, okay.
They called me and they asked for a conference. I said, can we meet in Aksyon Radyo? Because I would feel safe.
So they haven't updated you since then?
Yes, ma'am.
It's only been... Well, a little more than a month.
Yes,
ma'am. I think we need to... Is there a representative from ES here? No. None. We invited them, but they didn't send a representative. So, may we please... I request...
I will also leave this... Not because I want to unburden myself of having...
I'm not sure... Wait, hold on. We will just photocopy it,
yes,
but we will not keep it in our possession, the original, because
yes,
you might need it later on also.
Yes, ma'am. No.
Make sure you keep it in a safe place. We will. But we would want a copy.
Yes, Your Honor. Also, I would like to furnish the committee through Senator Grace Po this profile of SPO2 Rex de los Reyes, a bemedaled police officer, including this comprehensive report regarding the assassination of SPO2 Rex de los Reyes, a conspiracy of drug syndicates, PNP scalawags, and dirty politicians. I just received a copy of this, last month. And I do not know the authenticity or veracity of the information contained herein, but... For whatever it is worth, I am submitting this to the committee. And by the way, Madam Chair, if you allow me, I don't want to monopolize, but we have been very vocal in advocating illegal drugs in Iloilo City. I was once a rabid ally of Mayor Bilog, although in 2010, when I ran for councillor, I belonged to PMP and UNA. until now, although we have an alliance as he is from Liberal. But before I go to Mabilog, I was cut short earlier about the photographs of one of the men identified by Pedea who accompanied Mr. Melvin Odicta. May I respectfully ask the Secretariat to please show that again, because Senator Soto was not there in Iloilo City. This is something that I want to emphasize, because at the end of the committee hearing, Your Honor, you emphasized to Mayor Mabilog, and I could vividly recall when you said, Mayor, pakiimbestiga nga to, referring to Mr. Espinosa. I know you can also recall that, Your Honor, when you told Mayor Mabilog, Mayor, because the question is there. There, left hanging was, Jingjing Espinosa, according to him, he responded to your question, where did he get his money? Because he has a palatial house in Iloilo City, a five-story house with fleets of vehicles. So you asked him, what is his source of living? He said, pangisda po. And until now, Mayor Mabilog has not initiated any investigation insofar as Jingjing Espinosa is concerned with in reference to your directive, Madam Chair. This is Jingjing Espinosa, an incumbent barangay official, barangay kagawa. This is his wife, an incumbent barangay captain. Can you please post that picture? These are your children. These are all minor children. That is Espinosa, his sister, his brother, and younger sister. These are his cousins. And this is Barangay Kagawa, Jesus Jingjing Espinosa. What is painful, Your Honor, is this. After the inquiry, the Chief of Police of Molo Police Station, one of the districts in Iloilo City, made a pronouncement that he said, all the firearms shown in the picture are just replica. They said, it's just toy guns. Please may ask.
So he made a quick conclusion.
They made a quick conclusion.
Did he even show the toy guns?
Yes, there was no showing of the guns.
None.
They have not visited the house of Jingjing Espinosa. They have not asked for the presence of Jingjing Espinosa for an investigation. And yet, right there and then, upon seeing the pictures I have given them, they said, oh, these are all replica. Can you pause for a while, ma'am, the picture of the wife of Jingjing before his picture? This is the wife of Jingjing Espinosa. She is an incumbent punong barangay or barangay captain. Through our naked eye, there are police officers here. Can we zoom a little bit? AK-47, a standard M16 armor light rifle, and another rifle with M203 grenade launcher. I don't know if in Divisoria we can find this kind of firearms, Your Honor, because I wanted to buy one for my kid. Because upon seeing, Your Honor, the picture, who would make a conclusion that this is a toy gun? Yet, in effect, the police is still trying to cover up. The police in Iloilo City is still trying to cover up. Why? Because of the friendship of Mayor Mabilog and Jingjing Espinosa, you don't want to lift a finger. Precisely, we have been crying, we have been shouting in Iloilo City that narco politics is prevalent. Because you see, other picture of Jingjing Espinosa, please. Even minor children, those children of Jingjing Espinosa.
Excuse me, maybe we shouldn't anymore. You can show it, but for the media, can you please
yes, because there are minors. Yes, I agree, minors, Your Honor. Yeah. I'm sorry.
So it's okay. I think you made your point here that the children should really not be carrying those firearms. Whether they're toys or not, That's sending out a message. You're a barangay kagawad, or a barangay captain. It's advocating violence. What's puzzling to me, police chief superintendent, bakit yung chief of police ng Molo mabilis pang nagbigay ng conclusion na yung mga baril na yan laruan? He didn't apparently investigate yet.
Yes, but Chair, we will conduct investigation on that.
But what is your update on the police situation on the ground? Did they give you any updates? On, did you file a case against Mr. Espinosa now?
Ma'am, I've talked with the regional director of Pro 6. He said that during the time of the previous RD, General Cruz, these replicas were surrendered to them. It was already surrendered to them. And then right now, as of this date, he has one caliber 45, which was already surrendered to the police.
The replicas were surrendered?
Before, ma'am. During the, they have a record that these replicas were surrendered before.
When was this?
During the time of General Cruz. But they don't have the date, ma'am.
Surrendered meaning, did they also...
Yes, ma'am. Maybe...
They kept it?
Yes, ma'am. It was surrendered to them.
So, nasa ito?
So, just to confirm that, it was confirmed that it's a replica.
Okay. I would like to clarify this. It was surrendered, and did the police have custody of it already? O ibinalik sa kanya at sinabi, sige, replica lang yan sa
iyo. We will get the records of this, ma'am.
Need the records because if it was surrendered and they certified it replica, number one, we're not sure if that's actually a replica. So, did they take a picture of it?
Yes, ma'am.
And if they sought custody of it, then we'd like to have it. I doubt that we have a replica like that unless...
We'll get...
And even if it's a replica... I don't think you're allowed to import a replica like that. And I don't think those are sold in toy stores anywhere. I'm highly doubtful about it.
Madam but Chair,
we'll get the records from Post.
To follow up on your point, the committee would like to see it. Where is it? If it was surrendered, who is having custody of these replicas? Or did they give it back? If they gave it back, where is it? And why did they give it back? The committee would like to know that.
We will get the records from Pro 6. On your question a while ago, ma'am, the firearm licenses of Dicta Senior were already cancelled by FEO.
When did they cancel it?
I haven't got the date, ma'am.
If it was already cancelled, it was just issued in 2015, eh? Last year, meaning
yes,
they just recently cancelled it.
Yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am.
Based
yes,
on
ma'am.
What? Number one, why? Because of this particular
because
involvement. Number two, if it was cancelled, are they making an effort to retrieve it from him? Did they go there already? Because that means they should
these
know.
Are love.
You will get the information, ma'am. With Udicta Jr., ma'am, they haven't got the original copy yet of the case filed with the court, so they are waiting for the records of the filing of cases against Olicta Jr. But with Espinosa, they are still have to confirm the middle name because there are a number of names with Jesus Espinosa Jr. So they don't know which one of these is the barangay chairman, the official that was referring to.
Okay, going back now to the actual cases filed because of this incident. Sinabi ninyo out of 20, wait, let me go back. Out of 20 men, only 3 cases have been filed and they have identified 5 more. So, was there a case filed already against Espinosa?
Yes, as I mentioned earlier, that the respondents Melvin Odicta Jr. Senior, Odicta Jr. and Jesus Jingjing Espinosa for grave threats, robbery, and qualified trespass to dwelling last November 26 month.
So,
So what is the status now, General?
It's
pending with who?
Under the prosecutor's office of Iloilo City, probably.
Attorney Dedumo? I think that's a TV station microphone. You use it.
Sir, as per the report from the Office of the City Prosecutor to the Prosecutor General, the case was submitted for resolution third week of January, sir. The case for the charges for trespass to dwelling, robbery, and grave threats against respondents Melvin Odicta Jr. and Sr. and Jesus Jingjing Espinosa. The case was filed by Police Inspector Flora. Okay. Thank you, sir. Yes,
for resolution, so wala pang resolution?
Submitted for resolution. No resolution yet.
When do you expect that?
Sir, maybe February.
Did you actually have a chance? Do you know if in the police station they actually had a chance to interview in person the Odictas? For sure, si Jingjing Clemente. Yes. How about those two? I mean, Jingjing Espinosa.
Sir, I'm sorry. I don't have that information as of now. What was relayed to me is just the...
But is it possible, attorney, that they will submit it already for resolution without having met the two other persons mentioned?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Madam Chair, this question, based on the allegations of Aksyon Radyo and Councillor Nava and some other personalities in Iloilo. No, my question is for PIDEA and PNPH. Are these personalities mentioned in your crosshairs? They're in the order of battle or in the crosshairs?
Your Honor, we submitted a confidential report to the chairman regarding the drug personalities operating in Iloilo.
In Iloilo.
Because during the last investigation, we did not mention it in public because there are ongoing anti-drug operations.
When did you submit this to us? Today?
No, Your Honor. A long time ago, after the Iloilo investigation.
You only received it today.
That was long time ago, Your Honor. We have a receipt copy.
What about the agent? They are in your crosshairs?
Yes, sir. They are listed.
And therefore, this is the best chance for you to get them?
Yes, sir.
And diba? Yes, yung mga big time, hindi natin mahuli. Hindi natin madali ng humahawak eh. Hindi yes, humahawak ng droga yung mga yan, diba?
Yes, sir.
Kaya conspiracy, that's the reason I incorporated conspiracy in Republic Act 1965 eh. Oh, hindi natin madali ng conspiracy. This is a very good opportunity for you. Matindi yung kaso. I think they being in your crosshairs, you should step up and follow up on these cases, even if it's not about illegal drugs. In that case, you know. Aside from that, if you don't mind, and if the chair will allow, can we have a short brief on the drug trafficking and drug abuse problem in Region 6, particularly Iloilo, and also the 8 South after that? Mr. Ledesma, yes. A brief overview of what's happening in the drug trade in Iloilo.
Would you prefer a briefing outright or a PowerPoint presentation? I can give you an overview.
Just an overview will do now, and please submit a copy to us, you know, of the entire picture.
Yes, honorables, the drug situation in Iloilo is Region 6 is considered a consuming region. We have not monitored the existence of a clandestine drug laboratory or chemical warehouses that are operating that would suggest an existence of one. Marijuana cultivation is backyard. We don't have plantation-sized marijuana sites that is existing in the region. We have an estimate of about 62,000 substance abusers in the whole region with a population of about 8 million. We have two major drug groups that are operating and based in Iloilo City and has about 200 drug personalities listed as our targets for the Iloilo City and province. We have 15% drug affectation rate, barangay drug affectation rate in the whole region. And for the past 2 years, we were able to drug clear 225 barangays, specifically in Iloilo province and Iloilo City. And for the year 2015, we were able to conduct with the PNP 800 operations, positive operations, arresting 1,900 personalities, filing 2,053 cases, and seizing a total of 83 million worth of illegal drugs, most of which are methamphetamine hydrochloride or shabu. Currently, we the past 2 years, sir, ma'am, Iloilo City, Iloilo City Police, the Police Regional Office, and PDEA, we have stepped up the campaign against illegal drugs by employing drug clearing operations. Conduct this, and it's considered the best practice. We have put up task forces dedicated to drug awareness, education, conducting symposium consultation in barangays, in public schools, together with the city government and city police. We are on the verge of creating our interagency drug interdiction task groups based in the ports to curb domestic drug smuggling. As I have mentioned earlier, our region is considered a consuming region, not a producing region. So all of the drugs are actually being smuggled into the region. So that's why kami sa PDEA, we're forwarding our defense to the seaports and airports. While we still continue to conduct supply reduction and demand reduction campaign together with the local executives and the anti-drug abuse councils and the supply reduction with the PNP, Your Honor.
Is there prevention, preventive education campaign in Iloilo? Who conducts it?
We have formed a task force on anti-drug abuse and education.
PDEA, DDB.
PDEA and DDB, together with the PNP, local government, social welfare, and DOH, Senator.
When you say local government, what particular branch of the local government help you?
City Anti-Drug Abuse Council, the city government.
All right. What about rehabilitation? Is there a rehabilitation center in Iloilo, government or private?
Yes, sir. We have a government-run under DOH a treatment and rehabilitation center based in Pototan. However, Senator, it's the capacity is quite small compared.
That is government-run.
Yes, sir. Under DOH.
What about private?
We have one in Victoria City in Negros Occidental and one in Oton, Iloilo. However, the one in Oton, Iloilo, Senator, has recently closed down.
Expensive?
Yes, sir.
Just to before I ask the HSO to also give us a brief, Madam Chair, I want to put emphasis into this. No? The pronouncements of some of others, no, saying that removing the problem of illegal drugs is easy by removing the pushers and the drugs itself, no, it's inaccurate. You can't do that. You'll never win.
Yes.
Killing all the pushers, removing all the drugs, is not enough. The real battle is in the other half, which is stop people from using, rehabilitate those who are already using, and those who are have not tried, prevent them. That is why, if you have emphasis on enforcement and prosecution, there must be equally or even more emphasis on preventive education and rehabilitation. If you don't do that, we will never solve the problem of dangerous drugs. That's why I asked also for that point in Iloilo. May we have Edsalt answer the same question? Give us a brief on the situation in... Oh, by the way, one last question. Point blank, blood. Mr. Ledesma, is there narco-politics in Iloilo?
Please answer the question.
Yes. Senator, if we define narco-politics, it's narcotics influencing politics.
Yes.
We receive all kinds of reports, especially during campaign election period. What PDEA's role is to validate and verify the information. What we can assure you is that when we validate and verify, it would warrant a negation operation, is that we would do the negation operation without fear and favor, regardless who gets involved. That's why, ma'am, when you were there, we briefed you that we were able to arrest 53 government officials, employees, and other law enforcement officers through the years. What I'm trying to say, Senator Soto, is that we just arrest whether they're whoever they are. We don't look at if they have a barangay kagawad or barangay captain titled before their names or for whatever reason. So we can only confirm that there is narco politics if we arrest them. We cannot confirm or speculate based on reports we get, because through the years, sir.
So based on your answer that you've arrested those you've already arrested, then it's present. There is narco-politics.
Yes, to those that you've arrested.
The question, without having to mention the name, but if they were paying attention closely to our hearing today, there's some allegations of a connection between the barangay Kagawad and a powerful government official. Have you seen the connection between the two in your preliminary investigations?
We've seen the pictures also.
But based on what they submitted, have you done your own initiative of an investigation to connect the two?
Yes, ma'am.
And does it look like there is an alliance between them?
With regards to illegal drugs, no.
Okay. I would like to ask Attorney Rex or Attorney Piad, when I met... when we conducted the investigation in Iloilo, I had asked for the mayor to go and check on this Kagawad. Is there a reason why there's no report on what he's found out about it or an explanation about it?
Good. In as far as Mayor Mabilog is concerned, Your Honor, he had checked, he had verified. But as to the filing of the cases, Your Honor, it is with the police, Your Honor. So
he doesn't have any recommendation or findings to submit to this committee?
As to that regard, Your Honor, we don't have any recommendations and findings, Your Honor. The job is with the Philippine National Police, Your Honor. They were the ones who conducted an investigation. In as far as Mayor Mabilog is concerned, Your Honor, he is only exercising supervisory functions, Your Honor. He cannot control these barangay officials, Your Honor. So
he can call them.
The question of the chair is: you said he investigated. He tried to verify or something to that effect.
Yes, sir.
So what did he say? What is your finding?
There is no findings yet, Your Honor. There is no findings up to now, Your Honor.
Attorney, wouldn't at least the mayor issue a statement? That's his barangay captain, right? That's his kagawad.
Yes, yes.
Under him. And if you feel you're the mayor and your kagawad, yung mga kagawad mo is putting under jeopardy his barangay, wouldn't... I'm sure the mayor has some discretion over this.
Yes, Your
Honor. So he continues to exercise being a nakagawad in that area?
Yes, they still do, Your Honor, because there's no... If these kagawads, Your Honor, will be charged with cases, Your Honor, then the mayor will not support them. The mayor will not assist them, Your Honor.
Yusek Kaknak, do you have any information now on Espinosa? I'm sure that you've conducted, because the allegations that he has his wealth is beyond his livelihood reach. He continues to be a kagawad. Meron na ba kayong findings on Espinosa that you submitted, Mr. Ledesma?
Ma'am, we conducted an investigation after the legislative meeting we had in Ioilo. We cannot establish any legitimate business he has as of the moment. He may be living off a big inheritance or must be getting money from maybe a big tub in his house, but we cannot establish any income-generating legitimate business that he is operating that would suffice.
Are there any limitations in the law that control you from further investigating his income source?
There's a lot of limitations in the law.
Please name them, because this is in aid of legislation. What limitations?
The bank secrecy law.
Bank secrecy, what else?
Anti-wiretapping law.
Okay. I think also the freedom of information where your sala needs to be made available to the public. Aren't they required to submit a salian? Mga barangay kagawad?
Yes,
ba may salian yung mga barangay kagawad na yan?
Yes, Madam Chair. And while you're at it, may we ask the committee, secretariat, and I think this is well within your power, to ask, because it is in aid of legislation and we are investigating, to ask for a copy of the ITR of that personality.
Oo nga, yes.
Ano?
Exactly.
Sila, yung tatlong involved na yan that you are suspecting.
Mr. Ledesma, go ahead, please.
Yes, can I add some more? Yung mga prerequisites, ma'am, for an anti-money laundering investigation, to launch an investigation, may mga predicate crime kasi na mga requirement. And kahit, sir, na as you were mentioning earlier, this is supposed to be a big opportunity for us to hit the top echelon of the drug trafficking organization kasi hindi naman sila, sir, humahawak. But the case filed upon our review also does not qualify for any of the predicate crimes required in conducting or launching an anti-money laundering investigation because it's not
only robbery and also
that may
grave threat.
Yes, ma'am. And based on how it's running, ma'am, the case filed may even be eventually downgraded. That's what I've heard locally.
Even then, Madam Chair, the point is you can get them off the street. Diba? That is the important thing. Get them off the street because they're the ones destroying the youth of Iloilo and Iloilo per se. Okay, Madam Chair, may we continue with my previous question with the aid sought naman. Anong briefing nyo sa amin, status ng dangerous drugs sa Iloilo?
Magandang umaga po, Madam Chair, Ginoong Zota, sir. So for, by the way, sir, AIDG na po pala, Anti-Illegal Drugs Group, hindi na po kami task force. Thank you, sir. So for the barangay, I will limit my briefing to Region 6, covering Iloilo. So for barangay drug affectation, out of the 4,051 barangays in Region 6, 509 are affected, which constitute 12% of the total population. Now for the illegal drugs personalities in Region 6, this is DI, our Directorate for Intelligence Source. We have two identified financiers, 179 users, 478 pushers, with a total of 741 identified drug personalities.
Two financiers again?
Yes, sir.
Two financiers and then?
Two financiers, 179 users, 478 pushers, yes, sir, and zero cultivator with a total of 741, sir.
The two financiers?
They are listed, sir.
Can you give me a copy? Can you give us a copy?
Yes, sir, we will provide a copy.
I know you do not want to name the names because you can be held into court by them, hello?
Yes, sir.
But we can.
We can, sir.
We have parliamentary immunity. If I read out their names, they cannot do anything about it. No? So,
yes, sir.
Give us a copy.
I think we should read out the names in the order of battle of... I would also like to...
I will probably discourage that because that will give them the warning sign and they will probably hide.
But maybe, Senator, can you provide our office with the wanted drug pushers who are at large right now? Meron bang mga ganon? Na hindi pa ninyo nahuhuli at large, but they already have a case. Therefore, we can make their names public. Do you have, about how many do you have, sir? Mga at large, ha, na may mga drug cases.
Senator, we call it a wanted list, Your Honor. So we will look at the list and submit it to you, Your Honor.
Can you submit it to me by tomorrow, by later, in the afternoon?
Yes, Your Honor.
Dapat yan. See, this is exactly the point that we're trying to make. Eh. It's a wanted list that needs to be accessible immediately. Like in all police stations, meron ba niyan? All police stations, a list of the wanted personalities, it should be available on a government website. I would like to know if you have that. Is it?
We have a government website, but we don't post our wanted...
Kaya nga eh, para makatulong eh, di ba? Is there a prohibition in the law that says hindi sila pwedeng pahiyain? Kaya nga wanted eh.
Your Honor, may I make a correction? For people who were already charged in court and are covered by a warrant of arrest, we have a list and we publish their faces and their names.
So you have those individuals at large now?
Yes, Your Honor. With
okay. Do you have that list now? I'm saying how accessible is that information to the public? Kasi that needs to be, kung wanted sila. Correct me if I'm wrong, ha?
Nasa website natin.
Yung top 10, sir.
Sige, saputin mo kung meron.
Senator.
Let's continue the hearing. Alan, okay ka lang? Parang nakatulog ka na yata dyan, ha? Off the record yan, ha? Mga kasamahan niyo yan, ha? Okay. Teka muna. Di ba pag wanted and then at large, dapat yan available to the public para malaman, makatulong sila. So, it's not your fault. Is it there with you now? Do we have a... No, because we're trying to do this also oversight, di ba, Mr. Ledesma? And if you've been very good and helpful. We would like to improve our initiative in catching all of these drug pushers or drug dealers. But we need to know, is there a way for the public to get access to their faces, and is it in our website anywhere in PDEA? Nasa website po ninyo?
Yes, Your Honor, but the list are the high-profile targets, but we will improve our database so that we can include those who are charged in the regional offices. And
sige. So what you have are high-profile lang?
Yes, Your Honor, the Chinese drug lords who were charged have pending warrants of arrest but cannot be located, Your Honor.
Sige. But anyway, give me a list of all of them.
Yes, Your Honor.
Even the low and the high-profile cases.
Yes, Your Honor. We will comply, Your Honor.
And then it would be suggested also that when you go to the PDEA website, dapat mabilis lang parang these men or these women are now wanted by the police. Para makatulong, di ba? Meron bang reward? Meron? In some cases?
No, Your Honor, because the reward is given to informants after they are arrested with the drugs. So if you just arrest them and there are no recovery of drugs, because the reward is based on the volume of drugs that were recovered, Your Honor.
Okay, but Do you not have a program wherein if an individual gives a tip, this is where this person is hiding and you're able to arrest him, wala kayong incentive ng mga reward money na ganon?
It's not going to be covered by the Dangerous Drugs Board regulation, Private Eye, Your Honor.
But if there's a private individual who would like to help, pwede?
Yes, Your Honor.
There's no limitation in the law?
Yes, Your Honor. If it leads to the arrest of a drug personality and the recovery of the drugs, the basis for the computation of the reward is the drugs, the volume of drugs recovered, Your Honor, and its purity. So if it is a clandestine laboratory, it depends on the size of the clandestine laboratory, Your Honor. It's 2 million if it is a large, moderate size, 1.5, and 1 million for the small or kitchen type. So we welcome the cooperation of our public to provide reports to
us. But would you suggest an amendment in your regulation so that you can actually also have funding for the most wanted?
Your Honor, we will be happy if there will be an amendment, provided that there will be a specific allocation for this, because as of now, we're just relying on our intelligence fund to finance.
Kasi ito yung maganda eh. How many? For example, our top wanted individuals are numbering into 10. Let's say 10. Even if the government spends 20 million, 2 million each, that is a small price to pay to capture these men who are at large. I mean, I'm just saying, it might be able to help. Anyway, going back, what I'm also worried about is the safety also of our informants, or not informants, of the individuals who are reporting to us, Councillor Nava, Mr. Tia, the ones from Iloilo. So I'd like to hear from you. Are there any threats to you now? What can we do to protect you?
That's normal, Your Honor. The first time that I have identified, because at the time, nobody would like to identify the personalities involved in the video. When Aksyon Radyo reported it and posted it to social media, even the police are mum on the issue. Nobody would dare to name names. So when I was interviewed by Aksyon Radyo, Councillor Nava, do you know any of the individuals shown in the video? I said, yes. But one is Barangay Agawa ni Sus Jingjing Espinosa, the best friend of Mayor Mabilog. So after that, they asked me to execute an affidavit in support of that. The following day, I already received a barrage of text messages threatening me. So I just go to police to have it blotted. I went to police regional director, General Diaz. I asked him that these are the threats, these are verified, and every night we couldn't sleep because motorcycles are simply casing my residence.
Until now?
Until now. So immediately, Regional Director Diaz, General Diaz, sent me police officers just to make sure that I would be safe. But because of the COMELEC prohibition, my request for security was denied. So it's all right.
Padilla, can you help?
Your Honor, there is a COMELEC ban on the deployment of bodyguards. And if we want one, we need to request the COMELEC for an exemption.
It's all right, Your Honor. What I fear is not for my life, but I fear for the young people in Iloilo City.
But we will request the regional director to provide security coverage, Your Honor, not bodyguards.
Yes, please. If you have anything in your power that can at least augment what the law now restricts, we would appreciate it. Of course, we would not want to have a martyr.
Yes, yeah, of course.
At this particular juncture, when we still have a lot to resolve. How about you, Mr. Tia? How's the situation now in your case?
Thank you, Madam Chair. From our end, it has been a bit of a frustrating crusade, if I may say so. Although this is actually nothing new, and as far as Aksyon Radyo Iloilo is concerned, we have been at the receiving end of a lot of prior and previous incidents already. I guess truth telling nowadays, all the more has its price. For the benefit of those who still are not in the know, last August 25, 2013, we reported an incident when minors from the adjoining Light Life district of the city sought refuge at the station. And we called for the assistance of the local or the territorial police. They called for SWAT, and SWAT assaulted the station. And in the guise of telling us that they thought we were suspects, they made the station personnel take off their clothes, their shirts, and were paraded downstairs as hardened criminals. On December 10, 2013, station personnel was shot, although not fatally, was shot in the leg. On December 12, 2013, something organic was thrown in the station. December 27, rotten eggs were again thrown on the station. And on March 21, 2015, fish and trails were thrown at the station. So there has been a series of an episode of assaults on the station, Madam Chair, Your Honor. We have taken this in stride, believing that we have to say something about the ills of society, and we firmly believe that drugs is one of those. What troubles us, Madam Chair, Your Honor, is the seeming lackadaisical treatment of even the local government unit. We're just supposed to be reporting what is happening, and local government government officials and police authorities are supposed to be the one to be acting on this. The mayor has had issued a prior pronouncement that drugs is not actually alarming in the city. In fact, we came up with a plug of some sorts. We had displayed on air, if only to tell the mayor that that should not be the case, because he is the local chief executive and he has to show people of the city something, and then should be at the forefront of combating the drug menace in as far as the city is concerned. I think the mayor has already reconsidered. What is even more troublesome at this juncture, Madam Chair, Your Honor, is that there is the public perception that the mayor has got something to do indirectly with getting support from PDEA-identified drug personalities. Of course, there will never be a drug connection, as Director Poludesma would have mentioned. There will never be a drug connection between a local chief executive and an identified, PDEA-identified drug personality. Logically, because they're not into it for drugs. And I'm not talking about the local chief executive, the city of Iloilo. They're not into it for the drugs, but the money. So there will be no immediate and outright drug connection. There will be a money connection. An identified executive assistant of the local chief executive has constantly been seen entering the premises of the compound of Mr. Melvin Odicta for a number of times. I think he has already stopped because this has already gotten out of hand and as far as he's concerned. I think Kagawad City Councilor Nava has also filed. There have been cases filed already because Kagawad Nava exposed that Mr. Melvin Odicta has been giving, and I do not know the truth of this, has been giving financial contributions, funds during the election to Mayor Mabilog.
How did you come up with that presumption?
I guess City Councilor Nava would have to answer for that, Madam Chair.
Yes, sir. Unless you want to continue with something else before we go to him.
Your Honor.
Thank you, Mr. Tia.
Thank you, Madam
Chair, if I may just say something.
Sir.
In fairness to Chief Superintendent Bernardo Diaz, the current Regional Director of Police Regional Office 6, he is deploying a mobile car in the radio station 24/7.
That is true, Your Honor. We appreciate the effort extended by General Benny Diaz. Only that anybody who understands how these threats of assassination or liquidation are carried out, these are not going to be done in places where the police are present.
Okay, Councillor Nava.
Thank you, Your Honor. It's a good thing that Mr. Tia has made mention of that statement of mine in Iloilo City. But before that, in addition to the statement, after that inquiry, Your Honor, there are a lot of black propaganda being employed by the group of Mambilog. First, after the inquiry, there is this 8-page white paper being propagated in the entire city of Iloilo, and that is that fictitious paper entitled "The Truth About Nava Goles Crime Syndicate." They're trying to imply that I am a leader of drug syndicate, and the members of my syndicate is Mr. Jan Pultia and the Aksyon Radyo reporters. So after that, there is this big posters in front of City Hall, Your Honor, showing your picture and my picture. And in that tarpaulin or poster, it seems to imply that you are telling me that I am an idiot because I had an extramarital affair. And you said, alam mo ba nakakasira yan sa pamilya, as if you're telling me or you're trying to tell me that is not moral.
To reassure you that did not come from us.
Yes.
Wala nga kaming tarpaulin pa.
But the mere fact that
is yan, meron na pala sa Iloilo.
Saan nakasabit?
The mere fact that it was built in City Hall. You can see the hands of
sa
the mayor.
Sa City Hall?
Yes, in front of City Hall building.
In front of City Hall building. Kaninong building nakalagay?
Sa plaza mismo, Your Honor.
Sa plaza?
Kasi ang City Hall namin, kaharap plaza. Yung sa plaza, may tarpaulin kami ng dalawa. Ni... ni Senator Grace po.
Bawal yun, attorney. Pag di nyo inalis.
So, may respond, Your Honor.
Ha?
Maybe respond, Your Honor. Or we let him finish. Yes, Your Honor. Your Honor, please, as to the fact of the first point that was being referred to by the good counselor, as to the fact that he was alleging that Mayor Mabilog received money coming from these known PDEA identified drug personalities. To be honest, Your Honor, we filed already libel case against the good counselor, Your Honor, for him to be able to prove it, Your Honor, in court. Likewise, Your Honor, in the aspect of the alleged white paper, Your Honor, the good counselor also filed libel cases against us, alleging that we were the ones who authored the said white paper. As to the fact, Your Honor, of the tarpaulin issue, we were all surprised when that there was subsequently a tarpaulin war in Iloilo City. First is this tarpaulin indicating the good counselor as an adulterer, Your Honor. Immediately after it was taken down, as to the identities of the personnel who posted it there, the police cannot identify. A few hours after, Your Honor, the good counselor also put a tarp on the car. The father of the good counselor put a tarp on the hood of his car, saying that Mayor Mabilog likes hot dogs, you know. And it circulated around the city, implying that the good mayor has some gender issues. So the following day, Your Honor, there were tarpaulins again posted on the streets. I was fortunately, Your Honor, able to see this, and I was the ones who personally took them down. Yes. And
as long as you remove it.
Yes, Your Honor. Mm. We pleaded again, Your Honor.
So you have a tarp war, huh?
Yes,
not
Your Honor.
A turf war, a tarp war. Okay.
We pleaded, actually.
Just to clear the air about politics, you know? I just want to make sure. Are you running for mayor, Councilor Laba?
No, Your Honor. I'm still running for re-election as my third term as city councilor.
Because if you're running for mayor, all these would have a different color, no?
May I respond to that?
Councilor Laba, teka muna. The tarpaulin that had our picture together, yes. How long was it in front of the City Hall?
About 4 hours, Your Honor.
4 hours lang naman.
It was installed at 6 a.m. after Aksyon Radyo made a flash report that we such a tarpaulin. After 4 hours, somebody took it and we do not know because I have been asking Mayor Ambilog to provide me a CCTV footage so that we will know who are the persons responsible.
Meron ba? May kuha?
They could not give me, Your Honor. They said, walang namin nakuha eh. May CCTV po lang may nakuha. So, how if he's sincere, Your Honor, in determining...
Your Honor, no, please, maybe respond, Your Honor. Actually, Your Honor, the tarpaulin was taken down before 8 o'clock in the morning when people came in. When, as to the CCTV, Your Honor, the building administrator told us that there are no CCTVs outside of the City Hall. The CCTVs are focused on the entrance, Your Honor. But as to the perimeter, I think there was none, Your Honor. That was stated by the building administrator.
Yeah, please may continue about the... Because I have not made a statement about that campaign contribution. It was Mr. John Paul Tia who made mention about
that. Okay, go ahead.
Now, Mayor Ambilog and I have been very good friends. I am his rabid ally. People in Iloilo City know that. When we both ran in 2010, although he belongs to the Liberal, I belong to PMP, we had an alliance in the local politics in the city. And I became his very good friend because since his childhood, he is the classmate of my brother in SPED and UP. So I made a point that I showed my loyalty to him. I showed my loyalty to him, Your Honor. Everyone in Iloilo City knows how close we are. I am his rabid defender. I always defend him, even in Aksyon Radyo. I have been speaking in behalf of the mayor. We parted ways in 2015 because I could no longer stomach his corruption and even his drugs connection. In 2013 election, he received campaign contribution from Mr. Melvin Odicta. I was there.
What do you mean you were there? Odicta was there giving it to
yes,
him?
Yes, we went to the house of Odicta, Your Honor.
So you have a first hand?
Yes, Your Honor. Okay. So what happened is this. In 2010, his political opponent is Secretary Gonzales, Raul Gonzales, the late DOJ Secretary. At the time of Secretary Gonzales as DOJ, he was already exposing narco politics in Iloilo City. In fact, he had already initiated an AMLA investigation as to the ill-gotten wealth of Odicta and Jingjing Espinosa. So, Mayor Ambilog has the ally of Odicta and Espinosa. And in 2013, when Ambilog received the money, we were together, Your Honor. As a matter of fact, he told me, because we were always together. Even in Manila, we slept in his condominium here in Manila, in front of Emilio Aguinaldo College. And everybody knows in Iloilo City how close we were. In fact, Aksyon Radyo, John Poltia,
how close were you?
Very close, Your Honor. I know about him, Your Honor. I know everything about him. So, the time, he said, we will go to the house of Melvin Odicta because he will give us some contributions. I said, Mayor, I think that is unacceptable. I can tolerate your corruption, but I think that is already too much. He said, we needed that because we have an opponent who is very wealthy. So we went together, we rode on his Everest. Ford Everest colored gray runner. And we went to the house of Odicta. They talked in the living room. And then Odicta said, okay, Mayor, my pledge is 30 million pesos. So I just simply narrated a factual event which I have a personal knowledge. So Mayor Ambilog felt affected, so he file a libel case against me, but I'm willing to face that because I'm telling the truth. And truth is a defense in libel. I am a lawyer. I can defend myself.
Did you see that it was actually given to him, or did he just pledge it at the time? I'm giving you 30.
After that pledge, Your Honor, Meredicta handed him an amount. I narrated that over radio station because we have been advocating. After we parted ways, I said, enough of narco politics, enough of corruption. I exposed Mayor Babilog's shenanigans in government. In fact, I filed a number of cases against him before the ombudsman of all the transactions that I am a privy of, that I know of, that I knew of. I already filed a number of cases against him with all the kind of transactions in City Hall.
Like what? Give me an example of a corrupt practice that he may have been involved in.
He is involved in, even in the creation of that clamping ordinance. He wanted to implement a clamping program for the erring motorists who violate our traffic rules and regulations in the city. And he told me, because he is a businessman, he said, we will create a company and we will corner the contract between this private company who will provide a towing services in the city of Iloilo. The truth of the matter is that he is the owner.
Is that proven? He owns that company?
That's why we filed a case against him with all the supporting evidence. Traffic lights controversy. I went to Makati to verify from the supplier how much is the traffic lights. It cost only 500,000, Your Honor. And when he installed traffic lights in Iloilo City, which is unnecessary because the traffic lights installed there are approaching the bridge. You cannot see traffic lights within a bridge because it will affect the integrity of the bridge itself. And more so, it is overpriced. Even the gift-giving, sardines, rice, it is always overpriced. The anti-rabies vaccine, the ones who won the bidding, actually does not sell anti-rabies vaccine. It is poultry supply, Your Honor. Too much corruption in the city of Iloilo.
Thank you, Mr. Nava, for your courage, if it is. I just need, at this point, maybe for the record, just Director General Kakdak, based on his allegations, without specifying, do you have any leads about a connection right now?
It can be used as basis for an investigation, Your Honor.
Thank you. Attorney Piat.
Your Honor, please, maybe respond, Your Honor. It is very unfortunate for me to say this, Your Honor, but I think the good counselor, Your Honor, is only using this issue to make himself, Your Honor, famous, Your Honor. Come to think of it, Your Honor, the good counselor was never a part of the, was never a good friend to the mayor, Your Honor. They only knew each other in 2010, Your Honor, when the good counselor was under the picket of Mayor Mabilog to run as counselor for Iloilo City, Your Honor. Before that, they don't have any personal or direct participation, Your Honor. Secondly, Your Honor, the character of the good mayor, Your Honor, is beyond reproach, Your Honor. The city of Iloilo, Your Honor, had been cited for numerous awards. And in fact, Your Honor, the good mayor, Your Honor, was top 5 world mayor, Your Honor, as of last year, Your Honor, for world mayor search, Your Honor. So again, the good mayor had installed programs to curb illegal trade activities, Your Honor. And that can be confirmed by the PDEA as well as the PNP, Your Honor. But again, Your Honor, it is quite unfortunate for us to say that personal issues between the good counselor and the good mayor are being dragged into this controversy, Your Honor. So that's it, Your Honor.
Yes, I mean, we've seen a lot of improvement in Iloilo during the past how many years. But of course, we cannot discount also the fact that there are a lot of issues unresolved, particularly when it comes to drugs and the involvement of a city, a kagawad na, that you're saying the mayor has no power over, but I think politically the mayor can make a strong statement against him, and in fact even show it by example that he does not tolerate that kind of action from a, and even initiate an investigation himself on the lifestyle of this kagawad. Senator Soto.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Aside from that, to prove your point, no, that would be a good factor to show us or to show the people or whoever's interested what the mayor has done about this issue that we are tackling. The other thing is, what is the city doing about the anti-drug abuse program? Have you done?
May we be allowed to make a presentation, Your Honor? We have prepared a PowerPoint presentation. Briefly, Your Honor, less than 5 minutes, Your Honor.
All right.
After your presentation, we're going to ask Mr. Joel, Mr. Egko, for a brief response.
And the NUJP, perhaps, Madam Chair.
As well, yes.
Your Honor, we have here the program of the city government of Iloilo for the anti-illegal drug campaign, Your Honor. This centers on a three-pronged approach, Your Honor, involving the LGU through providing logistics and financial support through education, through the full activation of the Barangay Anti-Drug Abuse Council, Your Honor, as well as other Iloilo Anti-Drug Abuse Council. We also have, on the other hand, the PIDEA, you know, the cutting off of the supply of the illegal drugs, targets high value and rich, operation. We also have the PNP, Your Honor, for the barangay drug clearing street level operation and drug debt demolition. So the approach of the mayor, Your Honor, is three-pronged. In the part of the local government unit, there is the 100% activation of the Barangay Drug Abuse Council, Your Honor. There is the creation of the Task Force Anti-Drug Abuse and Education Board. This one is, as mentioned earlier by the Regional Director Polidesma, Your Honor, centers on providing education and seminars, Your Honor. That's what you recalled earlier, 50% of the battle against illegal drugs. There is also these billboard installations, Your Honor, to provide hotlines strategically placed in public plazas so that anybody who have information or tip might immediately get in touch with the person with the person's number indicated therein. And as a matter of fact, Your Honor, the numbers indicated therein are the personal numbers of Regional Director Polidesma, Your Honor. And we also have the installation of CCTV cameras and monitoring. As of the moment, Your Honor, out of the 180 barangays, we have 106 already, and it's still in the process.
Attorney Piad, do you have a CCTV in front of the house of Mr. Espinosa?
Do we have? I will still verify that. Please
check also.
Yes, please, Your Honor. And also, Your Honor, we have provided logistical and financial support, not only to the police, but also to the PIDEA, Your Honor. The Office of the Mayor had appropriated funds, Your Honor, for the establishment of a detention cell, Your Honor, within the PIDEA premises, Your Honor. And also providing vehicles, motorcycles, all that the concerned agency needs in order for them to curb and facilitate the curbing of illegal drug trades in Iloilo City, Your Honor. We have the Philippine National Police, which is tasked to charge, you know, street-level operators involving apprehensions and peddlers. So they're the ones in the streets, Your Honor, the Philippine National Police. And we also have the PIDEA, Your Honor, which focus more on a high-value target and high-volume targets, Your Honor. And this had yielded positive results, Your Honor. Next slide, please. We have the figures here, Your Honor. There is a number of lectures and symposiums conducted, Your Honor, as part of the information dissemination on illegal drugs, Your Honor. As you can see, the number of audiences reached by the said program, Your Honor. We also have the Task Force Anti-Illegal Drug Abuse Education, Your Honor. We also have this BADAC activation. No. Next slide, please. And this is the sample of the billboards, Your Honor, that are being placed in strategic places, Your Honor. Take note that the numbers therein are the personal numbers of a director, Polydesma. Next slide, please. And these are the approach, Your Honor, for information dissemination and education is modular, Your Honor. So these are being conducted or held in schools as well as in other educational institutions, Your Honor. Next slide, please. And these are the awarding of the police vehicles, Your Honor. These are the vehicles that are awarded to the Philippine National Police as well as the motorcycles, Your Honor, in order to aid the PNP as well as in the PDEA in the in their campaign against illegal drugs. And these are the figures, Your Honor. Crime volume dropped by 25% in 2014. The number of persons arrested, the number of cases filed in court, the percentage in the increase of positive operations conducted, the increase of illegal drug trades ceased, Your Honor. And also, Your Honor, the present status of the city of Iloilo. Next slide, please. And this also had yielded to positive awards, recognitions, and merits, Your Honor. These are some of the few, Your Honor. Next slide, please. And the Iloilo City government was awarded first place in government efficiency, Your Honor. And this was the one which the PDEA awarded the city government of Iloilo. As we can see, as you can see, Your Honor, there was a the on the left part that is the one of the judges in the drug courts in Iloilo. Another one is a representative, Your Honor, of Aksyon Radyo, the lady in white on his on her left side, Your Honor, is the Iloilo City Police Director. We also have the regional director, Your Honor. So the mayor, Your Honor, is in yellow. So he's also one of the awardees, Your Honor, by the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency. And these were the awards received by the city government of Iloilo, Your Honor, in the campaign against illegal drugs. So as you can see, Your Honor, we all have facts and statistics to prove the positive campaign of the mayor of Iloilo City in illegal drugs, Your Honor.
Yeah, okay. Attorney Biad, yes. I do agree. It looks good. It looks good on paper, especially if you're really doing it, no? It looks good. Now, my question is, where is the brazenness of the Odicta group coming from? Kung ganyang katindi ang Iloilo City government on the issue of illegal drugs, where is that brazenness coming from? You saw the CCTV?
Yes, Your Honor. Yes, Your Honor.
Di baril lahat.
Yes.
Ang tatapang. Pasok sa isang radio station.
And as far
may
as...
may police pang kasama. Honestly, Your Honor, ano sinasabi ni Mayor Mabilog dyan? At saka kayo, ano masasabi ninyo dyan?
Honestly, Your Honor, that is a big hurdle to the campaign of the mayor against illegal drugs. But again, Your Honor, the mayor is still ordering the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency as well as the PDEA, CIDG, to investigate on the matter, Your Honor. Because these are the lead agencies, Your Honor, who are the ones in the field. The mayor can only direct. In fact, Your Honor, after the incident, Your Honor, the mayor wrote Director NBI Director Mendez. He also wrote the top officials of the PNP, Your Honor, to look into this matter, Your Honor. That is as far as the Mayor Magubilog is concerned.
Do you confirm this, NBI?
Sir, I have
Will you inform the committee? Just to complete the picture.
Yes, Your Honor.
In fact, Your Honor.
Well, I wish you, if it looks really good on paper, and if you're really doing it, this kind of instances should not happen.
We agree, Your Honor. We agree. But again, we're still on the process, Your Honor. It's not yet 100% complete. And these subsequent events, Your Honor, subsequent turnout of events will could be a way of telling us that these are still issues left to be addressed or answered. So we're still working on that, Your Honor.
All right, Madam Chair, may we now hear from the National Press Club and the NUJP also.
Thank you and good morning po, Madam President. Madam Chair, Senator Soto. Icebreaker lang.
Hindi wala pa eh. Parang very optimistic lang kayo. Thank you.
Ever since po I became president of the National Press Club, and even before, no, marami na po tayong gantong nadinig na problema. Similar cases of harassment, killings, no, attempts. May mga kaibigan tayong nag-survive ng mga pamamaril. Buhay sila ngayon. But what makes this incident sa Iloilo po, ito yung nakita na lahat, very clear, clearly, sa tapang din po nila, and I admire them for that. Naipakita yung matagal na natin sinasabing problema po eh, yung sinasabing culture of impunity. They're so brazen, hindi natatakot. So, this incident clearly showed yung mga contributing factors dun sa problema. Imagine yung felon, convicted at that. Daming tao, gaganda ng kotse, daming baril. Tapos nung ginawa po nila yon, walang visibility yung police. I'm sure kung talagang may mga umikot, nakita may mga taong ganun sa radio station, baka nasundan yon. So yung pa isang problema sa law enforcement pa. Yung failure to protect yung mga citizens po, public safety, yung pong issue dito. Especially when it comes to ano, in terms of protection of the media, the radio station, Aksyon Radyo po. And then ano pa po isa nakita ng problema? This is a very complex problem po kasi that requires also a very complex solution eh. So isang problema dito yung weakness po ng ating justice system. Paano nakalabas ito? Convicted. Yun na nga po. But all those things, yung connection ng mga local alleged collusion ng mga local officials, either LGU, police, or whatever law enforcement agencies, nakita po dito eh. And we have here resource persons who personally, according to them, witness no, yung mga ganito pong pangyayari, collusion, or conspiracy, whatever we may call it. So, I can only speak for media protection. Yung, I mean, sa mga, on the part of journalists here, sila Sir Paul, and of course, yung mga sources namin. Siguro po, we have been, as far as the National Press Club is concerned, we have always been pressing the government to, we are considered the fourth estate. Di po ba? We have heard so many good comments about press freedom here in the Philippines, the freest in Asia and all that. But ang irony po dito, ang fourth estate naman dito, ang most vulnerable. Economics, walang protection in terms of safety. And the signs are all over. Eh, tayo po eh, hanggang ngayon ay number 2 pa rin sa ranking sa world, no? Being the second most dangerous place for journalists. During peacetime po yun. So merong difference. Iba naman yung Iraq, may gera po din eh. Dito, wala po. So ito po yung problema. Malinaw na malinaw. Andito yung lahat ng contributing factors sa kaso na ito. So ano po ang sa amin? We have always asked the palace. I'm covering the palace. So every time I go there, we remind them also na siguro magkaroon ng mas ngipin sa campaign, sa media killings. Paano po yun? Sabi namin, puro tayo empty promises eh. Asan yung pangako nyong sosob yung magatong kaso, yung hinahina ng justice system natin. And then how are you going to protect us? Me, Sir Paul, and the other journalists present. So ano ba dapat yung gawin? Ang ginawa po nila, I'm just telling a story. Ito po, personal experience namin sa NPC. Pinag-member kami ng Task Force on AO 35. Ito po yung task force nila, interagency body ito, on extrajudicial killings, including media killings. Nakaisang attend lang po kami doon, frustrated pa kami. It's as if the officers of that task force, hindi alam yung nire-report niya. Kaya nagagano na kami na makasama na, teka mali, ibang tao yung binabanggit. Pati yung mga numbers of killings, yung mga cases, iba-iba. So sabi namin, teka, walang puso. So every time I'm interviewed on the subject, lagi po sinasabi, kulang ang puso. Kulang tutok. Wala po eh. Reactive. Task Force USIG, Task Force on AO 35. Pagpatay na po yung tao eh. Kailangan po siguro maging proactive. How are we going to do that? we had suggested long before, yung para mag-create ng talagang body, nung proactive po ito, or probably the president can appoint a presidential advisor on the protection of journalists and their sources. If not, pwede po siguro mag-legislate tayo. You know, human rights is as important as press freedom. We cannot guarantee human rights without press freedom. Who's going to report about the abuses, di po ba? Bakit Commission on Human Rights lang meron? Maybe po, Madam Chair, we can legislate a commission on the protection of journalists and their sources. Hindi lang po yung kaming mga journalist eh. So mawawalan sa isa ang pagre-report namin kung ang mga source namin, katulad ni Attorney Nava, eh meron din pong threat na ganun. So insofar as the NPC is concerned, yun po ang aming mga suggestions, observations, at it's eye-opener po itong ano, nangyari sa Aksyon Radyo sa Iloilo. So yun po yun, sana ma-institutionalize yung protection, not reactive but proactive. Protection nga po, proactive. Hindi naman ano to, pagpatay na, tsaka lang po pumapasok ang gobyerno. So doon po kami nalulungkot. So we need better protection. We need to institutionalize those mechanisms by siguro. Yun nga po, either we must have in the future a presidential advisor on the protection of journalists and their sources, or probably we can come up with a commission on the protection of journalists and their sources. Yun po yun, para may nakatutok na. Wala po eh, walang. Whenever we say journalist killings, media killings, wala pong isang taong nag-claim ng responsibility.
Totoo, somebody, dapat may point person nga. To be able to give an update regularly, and also to be the person, the point person of the journalist to the government. Yeah, thank you for your very constructive suggestion, sir. In fact, I'd like to ask the DOJ attorney, I'm not sure, you've not been in our hearings before, but there's supposedly a hotline between the DOJ and media. Meron ng pangalan yun, Oplan. Are you aware of this? Under AO 35, Administrative Order 35.
I'm not aware of that, ma'am.
Can you please find out?
Yes, ma'am.
And then the PNP, are you aware of this? Because I remember it's also a cooperation with the PNP. Meron ba kayong NBI rin eh? Meron ba kayong hotline for media reports? I remember meron eh, di ba? Tatawag for emergencies. Di nyo alam, but that's okay. Attorney Dedumo, if you can please give us an update on that.
Okay. Yes.
Because I remember we were discussing that before with Attorney Revilla yet.
Madam Senator?
ASEC C.
Madam Senator, are you referring to Task Force USIG?
Perhaps. So would you like to give... Are you finished, Mr. Edco?
If I may add po, last.
Yeah. And then we will go with you, Mr. Villar.
We know everybody here would agree with me that the media is an open source of intelligence information. So if we can only work together with law enforcement agencies, siguro there are reports there na they keep in their archives or in their offices na hindi lang ma-validate. So ang sa atin po, for example, yung report about dito sa... Hindi lang po kasi ang problema dito, drugs. We have corruption, we have illegal gambling and everything. So siguro po ang mas working better, ang better working relationship is pag na-report sa media, follow up agad yung investigation. So red flag siya. I mean, si John Paul Tia bumanat sa ganitong pekwan. So kung meron po tayong nakatutok na agency, namomonitor yan naman eh. So nagre-red flag siya, sabihin, oh, bantayan mabuti yan. Parang ganun po yung... So yung, that's how proactive things should be here. So in terms of protection, I should mention yung isang totoong may narco-politics sa bansa, sa Colombia, I guess. They have their National Protection Unit. Yun po yung unit, anytime na may threat yung journalist, yan ang nagpo-protect. So dito po sa atin, wala. Although we're the second, they're only third. In terms of being living dangerously, no, as a journalist. So, yun po yun. Yun po lang po yung gusto ko yung add.
Thank you. We appreciate it, Mr. Edco. Oo nga, talagang we should be more proactive and there should be one person speaking just on media protection. Mr. Villarreal, go ahead, please.
Okay. To our good senators,
our chapter from the National Union of Journalists in the Philippines, in Iloilo, has promptly released a statement regarding the case, you know? And we call this not just a threat to Aksyon Radyo, but a threat to freedom of the press as a whole. It is what is being attacked here is the media institution. And two days ago, or was it yesterday, that the IFJ, to which the NUJP is an affiliate, has already drawn a grimmer picture of media in the Philippines, placing a second, no? Most dangerous country to practice journalism, second only to Iraq, which is besought by war. And their count was started way back 1990. So 25 years, there were recorded 46 media murders. Well, yeah, 146 media murders. What's sad there is that there are only 10 convictions. Among those 10 convictions, involves only the trigger. All of them are also only the assassins. Not one of the brains were even put there, but not even one of the brains behind those killings had a day in court. We had just completed our ninth Congress yesterday, and we had made a resolution to be more active and vigilant in seeking justice for the Ampatuan massacre. That was one dark page in media history in the Philippines. And to think that one of the brains already was allowed the bail and even running for a position back in Ampatuan. And that is media-related, or rather election-related media violence, and we're nearing elections. And we know that to a certain extent that shows, the incident in DYOK or Aksyon Radyo shows a lot of parties riding shotgun, walking the streets of Iloilo City with pure impunity and way, way above the law. That's very clearly showed there. We are not sharing, though, the view of other media organizations as to media being the source of information. Our mandate is to cover, to make the news. What we have reported in our Congress yesterday involves about 20 media murders from 2013 to 2015. And of this, two stands out. One is that of Troy Najid of Tawi-Tawi City, where he was killed simply because, the information available is that because he had volunteered us as a mandate, as mandated by the law to be part of that committee that makes the inventory on drugs. We think that we should not, that the mandate, we wish to take an exception of that mandate of the law. Our mandate is to cover the news, process the information, and deliver it. That is what we call it. And then there's also this case of Nilo Baculo Sr. He was the first writ of amparo granted to a journalist. Sadly, when it was remanded to the Court of Appeals, the Court of Appeals denied that the writ of amparo that he was trying to seek. And eventually, that was 2008, and eventually in 2014, or 6 years after, he was killed by the same suspected groups of drug lords and corrupt local officials as being involved in the killing. But we share that view that if the government really believes that
the media as being a partner to nation building, then it should take into consideration the creation of a world with also three square meals. But when we say three square meals, we're not talking about simply being paid better, but simply because, making sure that that pay continues. Therefore, they should also be safeguarded. They should also be secured, because with their death, of course, wala na rin yung magde-deliver ng pagkain sa mga bata. So that should be it. If the government really believes the media as a partner, then the government should protect the media.
Thank you for your statement, Mr. Villarreal. At this time, I would like to give a summary and highlights of today's hearings. Go ahead, Senator.
Madam Chair, just one request before you do that. May I request Police Director Miano to direct the Firearms and Explosives Unit to submit to the committee a list of those personalities who have been given a license to possess high-powered firearms. When I say high-powered, I don't mean the regular high-powered. I mean the automatic rifles, machine pistols, machine guns that are in the likes of the AK-47, you know, and Armalites that have been given these personalities. We want a list. How can an ex-convict be given a license for an AK-47 and a senator who is a reserve colonel in the Philippine Army not allowed? I want to find out why.
I am with you, Senator. I'm also very curious. And also, I'd like to know the update on, apparently they already revoked the permits for Odicta Senior. So I'd like to know if they're actively pursuing this. Are they going to the house of Odicta Senior? Do you know where he lives, right? Perhaps you can tell the PNP if they still don't have that information.
That includes the fact that these personalities have more than a dozen bodyguards. And the senator is alone, just relying on my firearm proficiency. No, so I need your help. Thank you.
Ma'am, sir, I submit the documents relative to the turnover of the replicas at the...
You have it? Yes, please. Yes. We will look at that. But sir, we're really serious. We want you to be able to confiscate those guns or revoke the permit. Since you already revoked the permit, what is the procedure? Do you confiscate the gun or... The guns need to be confiscated, correct? The ones for Odicta Senior.
Yes, ma'am. They are now in the process of communicating the revocation to the regional office.
We will follow up with your office. Even if we don't have a session anymore, we can still go ahead and receive your update. I'm sorry.
The Congress is not adjourned. We will be on break until May 28th. The Senate, the adjournment will be June 5.
So we can still follow up on this.
We are in force, yes. So.
Okay. So the summary and highlights of today's hearings. Number one, imported documents from DOJ, Board of Pardons and Parole, and Malacanang records were presented in the circumstances why alleged big-time drug dealers, the Odictas and Jingjing Espinosa, are roaming the city, contributing to the rise in drug addiction in Iloilo City. Let me emphasize, the city is a beautiful place, and this noxious problem of drugs must be resolved. Number two, new information surfaced that the alleged drug leaders are permitted to carry several guns with licenses. Now it's clear that, at least for Odicta Senior, that's been revoked. Armaments ranging from AK-47 to pistol calibers to shotguns to Colts, etc. These indicate laxity and inconsistency of the gun law, because apparently a senator can't even obtain a permit Senator Soto demanded the PNP to have a report on the situation. Number three, the PNP indicated that ES has been on continuous validation on the possible collusion between some PNP personnel and criminal syndicates operating in Iloilo. Initial cases have been filed in late November. Status now for resolution. Prosecutor's Office per DOJ, please give us an update also. Number four, Councillor Nava presented some documents on the alleged protectors, PNP and commissioned officers of the drug syndicates, that there is a mix of active and retired police officials and employees of the local government unit working with drug leaders in the area. We asked only for a photocopy, and apparently this was originally with the ES. The PNP would like to ask the ES what the status is of the original. Number five, Pideas Region 6, Mr. Paul Adesma presented a report on the drug situation in Iloilo City, that Pideas is on the verge of creating a multi-efforts to halt drug addiction, including anti-drug abuse, education, rehab, etc. Number six, is there narco-politics in Iloilo? Senator Soto asked straightforward. Pedea replied that they arrested individuals regardless of whether they are public officials or not, whether they are cagawads or not. This is an issue of utmost sensitivity and for Pedea to study carefully. Number seven, to link further the collaboration between government officials and drug leaders and the extraordinary wealth of those involved, the committee will request the SALN, the tax records, motor vehicle ownerships, etc., of those mentioned and indirectly connected to the issue, particularly Jingjing Espinosa. Number eight, the PDEA must publicize their wanted list of drug leaders and high-profile members of drug syndicates with active warrants of arrest. The reward system must be improved for the informants. This is for citizens and the public to help in this endeavor. Number nine, the committee commends the brave cause of Aksyon Radyo Iloilo, John Paul Tia, Councillor Nava, and all the citizens of Panay News for sharing information to solve this drug threat. And we implore the PNP, the PDEA, to please do what you can within the bounds of the law to protect these individuals who are present here today. Number 10, as a good information, we filed the bill exempting from wiretapping law cases of illegal and dangerous drugs. And we are going... It will be sponsored by tomorrow. This has been signed already by a majority of it, 14 senators. We also acknowledge the statements of Mr. Joel Egco, and also Mr. Fred Villarreal, Mr. Joel Egco, NPC Press Club, and National NUJP, Mr. Villarreal, SecGen. Magkasama naman kayo, di ba? Okay. We will now, this hearing is now currently suspended. We wanted to adjourn this hearing. Unfortunately, we still need additional information. Ms. Olea, if you have 1 minute, what do you want to add anything before we end?
Thank you. We would just like to take this opportunity to present our position on the Dangerous Drugs Act, because we think the Section 21 should be amended. The Section 21 states that in drug bust operations, media representatives should be present. And one of our colleagues...
A member of the media. Amended na, 2 out of 3. Pwedeng wala yung media, basta merong official.
Yes, sir, but the practice remains that in some of our chapters, some journalists are being required to join the drug bust operations.
The DDB is conducting seminars and workshops, not only for media practitioners, but also for judges, prosecutors. Even mga judges natin, hindi alam interpreted yung 9165. I hope you practitioners would involve yourself with the seminars and workshops being done by the DDB to understand more. We have already amended Section 21.
We've amended it in 2014.
We've taken that into consideration.
Wala na yung media.
Yes, but the statement there is or media. So it's being
used. Yan nga yung dati.
Yan yung dati. May bago na.
Please We will give you a copy of the new law.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. And please, yeah, as Senator Soto said, please attend also the seminar so that you'll also be empowered with the information with the new amendments. Okay, so this meeting is now suspended. Thank you.